Hello friends, welcome to Dreamweaver Crocheting with Love. In today's tutorial, I am going to teach you how to crochet this cute mini shoe keychain. Now, over here I made this mini shoe using two colors. For making the sole as well as this small bow, I have used pink color cotton yarn, and for making the main part of the shoe, I have used this yellow color cotton yarn. This is done using very simple stitches such as a half double crochet stitches. It is very easy to do, and when it is attached to the key ring to form a keychain, it gives a very cute appearance. So without delay, let's go into the tutorial. For this, the materials that I need are a 2.5 mm crochet hook. Here I have taken these two colors, but it will be quite contrast with this one, because for the sole and for the bow I will be using this yellow colored yarn, and for the main boot I will be using this pink colored yarn. A key ring to which we will attach our shoe to make it into a keychain, and this mini bow. The tutorial for this mini bow is already there in our channel. I shall give the link above for your reference. And scissors. So let's begin. For this, first we will make the sole part of the shoe. For that, I need to make a slip knot. And work 8 chains. Now here I have done with the 8 chains. Now I will be skipping the first 2 chains from the hook and working 2 half double crochets into the third chain. So here I have done the 2 half double crochets, and the initial 2 chains that I skipped will make 1 half double crochet. So in total I have 3 half double crochets. Now into the next 4 chains I will be working 1 half double crochet each. And I am left with just 1 chain. Into this last chain, I need to work 6 half double crochet stitches, all into the same chain. In case if you don't know how to work a half double crochet stitch, I shall give the link above so that you can just refer it and get to know how the stitch is done. Into the last chain I have worked 6 half double crochet. Now working on the opposite side, again we will be working 1 half double crochet into the next 4 stitches. Now into the first chain, already we have done 3 half double crochets. That was the first 2 chains that we had skipped, plus the 2 half double crochets work. So now I'll be working 3 more half double crochet into the same space. So that finishes the first row of our sole part. Now we need to slip stitch on top of the second chain. So we'll just cut off this excess yarn. Now for the second row, we need to chain 1, and into the same space I'll be working 2 half double crochet. One thing I forgot to tell you, that is for the first row, the number of stitches that we did were 20. That is, into the first chain we worked 6 half double crochet as well as 6 half double crochet into the opposite side, and on 2 sides we worked 4 half double crochet each. So in total it makes about 20 half double crochet stitches. So into the first stitch I'll be working 2 half double crochets. Again we need to work 2 half double crochet into the next 2 stitches. That means into next 2 stitches we'll be working 2 half double crochet each. So in total, in this place, I have worked 6 half double crochets. Now working on this side, we have done 4 half double crochets. Top of each of the half double crochet, I'll be working 1 half double crochet. So now we have reached the curved part of the sole where we had already done 6 half double crochets in the previous row. Now for this 6 half double crochets, we will be working 2 half double crochet each. So in total, we will be working 12 half double crochets. So I have completed the 12 half double crochet as I mentioned before. Now into the next 4 stitches, we will be working 1 half double crochet each. Again we are left with the 3 half double crochets. So into this 3 stitches, I will be working 2 half double crochets. So in total, I need to work 6 half double crochets. So here I have come to the end of the second row of our sole, and I will be slip stitching on top of the first half double crochet worked. So that finishes our sole for the shoe, and in total I have worked 32 half double crochets. So number of stitches from here on will remain the same, it won't change. But as we make the upper part of our shoe, we will be working reduction stitches to make the front part of the shoe. In that case, the stitches will get reduced for each row. So now I need to just cut off this yarn. And I'll be joining this pink colored yarn to make the main part of our shoe. So after attaching the new color, I'll make a chain, and then into the same stitch I need to work one back post half double crochet stitch. So I'll be just going to the post like this and pulling a yarn through it and then working a half double crochet stitch. So for each of the stitches, now since we have done 32 half double crochet, so we'll be working 32 back post half double crochets for the first row of our boot. We'll just continue working 1 half double crochet per stitch for total of 32 stitches. So here I have worked 32 half double crochet stitches on the back post. Now since we had worked the first row using back post half double crochet stitches, the appearance of the sole would be like this on the bottom part of the shoe. Now we will be slip stitching on the first half double crochet stitch, and that finishes the first row. Now for the second row, again I will be working chain 1, and we need to work 1 half double crochet stitch into each of the stitches till the end of the row. So in total, we'll be working 32 half double crochet stitches. Just continue working like this till the end of the row. So here I've finished with the second row, and at the end I have 32 half double crochet stitches. From third row onwards, we'll be working reduction stitches in order to narrow down the front part of our shoe. So for that, since we are having 32 half double crochet stitches, we will be working 1 half double crochet into next 10 stitches before working the reduction stitches. So chain 1, and from the same space I will start working 1 half double crochet into next 10 stitches. So I have done with the 10 half double crochet stitches. Now for the next 12 half double crochet stitches, we will be working the reduction stitch, that is working 2 half double crochet together. So for that, I will yarn over, insert my hook, pull up a loop, again yarn over, insert my hook into the next stitch, pull up a loop. I am having 5 loops on the hook, pull through all the 5 loops. So this is how a half double crochet reduction stitch is done. So in total, I will be working 6 sets. I have already done 1 set. So for the next 10 stitches, I'll be working 5 half double crochet stitches together. So in the front portion over here, I have done 6 sets of half double crochet stitches together. Now here I'm left with 10 half double crochet stitches. So on top of each of the stitches, I'll be working 1 half double crochet. So just continue till you reach the end. So here I've finished with the third row and slip stitched on top of the first stitch. Now for the fourth row, again we need to chain 1 and work 10 half double crochet stitches. Now that is till you reach the reduction part of the previous row. So the 10 half double crochet stitches are done. Now we have reached the part where we had worked 6 sets of half double crochet stitches together. So now we'll be clubbing the 2 stitches together to form 1 stitch. That is, again we'll be working 2 half double crochet stitches together. Since we have done 6 sets, so by the end we'll be left with 3 sets of half double crochet stitches together. This is the second one, and this is the third one. So again we'll be continuing with the working 1 half double crochet into each stitch for total of 10 stitches. So just continue till you reach the end. So here I've come to the end of the fourth row and slip stitched on the first half double crochet stitch. Now for the fifth row, again we need to chain 1 and work 10 half double crochet stitches. So now we have come to the place where we have worked the reduction stitches. We have 3 sets of reduction stitches, so we'll be clubbing all the 3 stitches together. That means we'll be working a half double crochet stitches for all the 3 stitches together. So 1, 2 and 3. So in total I have 7 loops on my hook. Again I'll yarn over and pull through all the 7 loops. Now again I need to work 1 half double crochet stitch into each of the 10 stitches that are left over. So just continue like this till you reach the end. So I have ended the 5th row and slip stitch on top of the first half double crochet. In total I have 21 half double crochet stitches. So from here on we need not work any reduction stitches. So from row 6 onwards you can work 3 or 4 rows depending upon how higher you want the shoe to be, because we'll be providing this cuff edge to our shoes like this. So I'm not exactly sure how many rows I'll be making. So once I'm done with it, I'll get back to you. So you just continue working 1 half double crochet into each of the stitches for next 3 to 4 rows. So the row starts like this. You have to just chain 1 and work 1 half double crochet into each of the stitches. So here after working the 5th row, I have worked 3 more rows of 1 half double crochet each. I felt this is tall enough, so I have cut my yarn. Now if you want, you can keep the shoe as it is, but we'll give a cuffed look to the shoe. So for that, I need to just turn on the sides like this. So in this way, your cuffed shoe is ready. Now the next step would be to attach the bow on the front part of the shoe. So we need not sew it since we have left with the 2 yarns. We'll just join it to the shoe like this. So from the inner part of the shoe, I have pulled one of the tails. Again, we'll be pulling the next tail like this. And then we need to tie knots between the yarns in order to fix the bow to the front part of our shoe. So just turn like this. So here I attach the bow onto the front part of our shoes. Now while cutting the yarn, I left somewhat 10 cm yarn so that it can be used for attaching our shoe to the last ring of the key ring. So we have to just go through the stitches like this till you reach the center part. and then go to the last ring. And attach it to the shoe. Just go through 3 to 4 times so that it is firmly attached. Then tie knots and cut the yarn. So that finishes your mini shoe keychain. I hope you found this tutorial really very interesting as well as useful too. So if you have any queries, please let me know through comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.